Yo, what's up, guys? This will be a continuation of Telltale Game of Thrones, and yeah, let's start.
Previously on Game of Thrones.
To ensure there's no trouble, Lord Whitehill will install a garrison of 20 men within your walls. You have a man you trust?
My son, Griff.
I suppose the Crown could be persuaded to secure Ironwood from House Forrester. Lady Marjorie might not look favorably on such an alliance, and it would infuriate Cersei. Although what would be amusing for me might prove rather dangerous for you and your house.
Father,
I'm going to kill you.
Is that so?
I'm glad I found you, my boy. It's been far too long.
Who the fuck is he?
My uncle.
Roderick?
Roderick, by the gods, it is you!
Sir?
Fetch the maester, hurry!
Fetch the maester!
Let her go!
The Lost Legion won't stop until you and your friend are dead.
She's been gone a while.
She'll come back.
If they catch her, they'll kill her.
They won't catch her.
She's costing us time. It's just that we need to get to Meereen. Every day we lose here is a day that Talia or Ryan could be hurt, or worse. You must return home safely, Asher, and... Well, you have a history of putting your faith in women who may not deserve it.
She's my friend, Uncle. She's been at my side for a long time.
Was it them? The Lost Legion?
Aye. Too many for us to take. I counted about 24, maybe more, as well as horses. About half a mile down the canyon, and coming fast. Had to run my arse off to avoid getting caught. It's nearly empty. You two care if I finish it off?
It might be a while before we find more water.
I'm dying, though.
We're better off saving this for later.
Well, I hope we enjoy it.
Right. We need to get moving.
The Lost Legion. We're 100 miles from Yunkai. When are they going to give up?
Never. They're still raw about T'Zaal.
Yes, well, perhaps you shouldn't have snapped his neck. There is such a thing as overdoing it.
Let me remind you, it was him who tried to kill us. I just returned the favor.
Oh, don't doubt it. You always did have a gift for that sort of thing.
It's only a matter of time before they overtake us. Ah! Bugger a harpy.
Can we double back?
Not without meeting our mates from Yunkai. We're well and truly fucked this time, Asher.
During severe winters, when the Skahazadan floods, it carves out great underground rivers in the sandstone.
And
when those waters recede, those rivers become caves. And those caves might hide us, if we can find them. I mean, we're trapped for the moment, but all I'm saying is we needn't die here. Just standing our ground.
Thank you, Malcolm. That's valuable advice.
Of course.
If he's right about this, I may actually stab him.
What do you think? Could we climb out of here?
Pretty steep, Asher.
And we'd be totally exposed if your friends arrived before we reached the top. Well, we...
It's not gonna happen. It's too unstable.
Do you think we could dig our way through? Or try to scramble over?
I don't know. Either will be slow and tricky. One wrong move and the whole thing could collapse on us.
Looks like we're not alone.
No obvious wounds. Maybe he died of thirst.
Listen.
That's water. I hear water.
From underground. There might be a cave nearby.
I think I see a light in there.
A way through.
Oh, we couldn't be that lucky. Oh, shit. It's them.
Ponte Fredon! Che si rinzi!
Shit! Come on! Go! They're behind us!
Garrod, it's good to hear you'll be a ranger.
Thank you.
I know you wanted this.
I'm ready to say my vows.
I didn't have many friends when I first arrived at Castle Black. Grin and Pip, they'd as sooner see me bloodied in the yard than offer a hand. Now, I'd die for either of them. Our brothers are all we have.
Finn.
Shows you what kind of ripe fools are running this place. I can't believe they made you a ranger. You're not fit for the job. You don't have any balls between your legs.
Like it or not, we're brothers now. Means we're gonna have to get along.
Don't count on it. You wouldn't even be here if you didn't have Snow leading you by the hand the whole way.
I'd keep an eye out for you if you weren't such an arse about everything.
You don't give a shit about me. No one around here gives a shit about me. They wouldn't even care if I... You know how many rangers are never heard from again in these parts? And I'm about to become one myself. All alone out here. Wildlings everywhere. Or wolves. Or, God, giant wolves.
It's all right to be afraid. Keeps you alert, keeps you from being too confident. Like the next time we fight. I'll remember that fist of yours rattling my skull and I'll think twice.
I suppose you're right.
You want a different assignment, because I hear they need someone to clean the shithouse.
See, that's why I got so fucking mad at you, Garrett. You're the closest thing I have to a friend.
You handled that well, Garrett. They say the old gods watch us through the weirwoods. More than watch us. They know us. The gods are not forgiving. We brothers have to be. We're here. After this, there's no going back. Now go. Take your vows.
In the eyes of the old gods, the Night's Watch offers you a place beside us. Now say the words for all to hear and embrace us as your own.
Hear my words, and bear witness to my vow. Night gathers, and now my watch begins.
It shall not end until my death.
I shall take no wife, hold no lands, father no children.
I shall wear no crowns, and win no glory.
I shall live and die at my post.
I am the sword in the darkness.
I am the watcher on the walls. I am the shield that guards the realms of men. I pledge my life and honor to the Night's Watch for this night and all the nights to come.
You knelt as boys. Rise now as men of the Night's Watch.
Welcome to your new family, Garrett.
We're men of the watch now. Means we get to piss off the wall whenever we want.
Didn't know you needed an excuse to play with yourself, Finn.
Garrett, you've got a visitor. Over there.
Well, who is it?
Do I look like your fucking squire?
Don't forget the practice shorts.
Uncle Duncan!
Garrett! It's good to see you. They told me you were at the Weirwood Tree.
I've missed you, Uncle. I never expected to see you here.
A business with the Night's Watch. A delivery of Ironwood shields to keep you all out of harm's way. That settles it, then?
Aye, the delivery looks in order.
Oh, the gods do grant miracles. You look well, nephew. I'm told you're a ranger now. That's good.
Uncle?
Things aren't going well at Ironwrath, Garrett.
I know. I heard the news about Ethan.
I wasn't there when it happened. Small mercy, I suppose. Not having to see our lord struck down with such barbarity. But House Forrester is nothing, if not resilient. Our house has survived for centuries.
Please tell me there's a plan. But we can't let them get away with this.
That's why I'm really here. Do you recall Lord Forrester's last words to you? Just before he died, Gregor's final command, spoken to you in confidence.
He said the North Grove must never be lost.
Indeed. But first, it must be found. I've been reading his journals, scouring the legends for any clue what Lord Forrester knew. I think I've found the answer. He describes a fortification, a protected citadel of sorts, hidden from the world, one filled with great power. It was scattered among his notes. Almost an obsession, a vital secret he protected at all costs.
And you think it's north of the wall?
His notes suggest as much. And you must find it, Garrett. The search won't be easy. But you're a Tuttle. Our lord knew you wouldn't fail him.
It can't be too hard to get north of the wall. I'm sure there's a way.
As a ranger, that shouldn't be a problem.
How am I supposed to find it?
The first chance you get to head north, take it.
And then?
You leave the Night's Watch behind, and strike out on your own. This is no small request I make. I know that. But there's no other choice.
I agree, Uncle. But how?
A brave answer, Garrett. This will help guide you. I found it hidden in Lord Forrester's strongbox.
What is that?
A page from our lord's journal, but one he tore out and kept separate. Why? I don't know.
It's a map. To the North Grove.
Aye.
I used to be frightened of Weirwood Trees. But before I was a man grown, I swear, I actually could hear them whispering sometimes.
This looks familiar.
What is it, Garrett?
Talia gave me this. Before I left.
Oh. Wait. Lord Forrester gave Ethan a similar one as well. Roderick too. I wonder.
Look. There's a clasp.
It must open.
I had no idea this was inside. Another Weirwood.
But why?
Maybe it's a key to solving the map.
Thank you.
perfect fit. Maybe it's telling us where to look on the map. Oh, it's the whole map that has to turn.
Aye.
Werewood's mouth. Uncle, whatever this place is, the North Grove must be near.
There's only one way to find out. Here, take this map. Everything we hold dear may well depend on your success. It's a lot to put on your shoulders. The lives of a whole house.
Well, I'll try, Uncle. It's no small task. I'm still just a squire.
I know what I'm asking of you. But I know you're up to the challenge. God's watch over you. You're the son I never had.
Let's go, Garrett.
I don't know. They're probably like little shards or something.
Wait, so like a weapon?
Well, you're pissing.
Well, that was rather mysterious. A stranger arrives and you're chatting him up.
Someone said it was your uncle looking for you. Well, what did he want?
Looked like you two had a lot to talk about.
Must have been important to come to Castle Black.
Is Castellan to House Forrester? They sell ironwood to the builders.
So you were just talking about lumber all that time?
It looked like it gave you something.
It was nothing. Let's go and celebrate.
Already keeping secrets from your brothers, eh?
Garrett's right. The wall's gonna melt before we get up there. Come on.
There are so many guests already arriving. And have you seen the wedding decorations they put up in the gardens? So beautiful. You know, we're as lucky as she is. Marjorie was but a lady when we were sent to serve at Highgarden. But in just a few days' time, we'll be attending to a queen at a royal feast. Where we're standing, we'll be able to see everyone. And everyone will be able to see us.
We've certainly come a long way, haven't we?
I've been meaning to say what I told you about my family. I hope I didn't make a mistake in trusting you.
If handmaidens don't help each other in King's Landing, nobody will.
Thank you, Mira. And you know I'll always help you too. Hold on, look. There he is.
Lord Morgrin?
No, next to him. Lord Tarwick. I don't want to be a handmaiden forever. And this wedding may be the best chance of meeting a husband I'll ever have. I have to go talk to him. Marjorie won't notice her for a few minutes longer. Could you make an excuse for me? Please. I'm not asking for much.
Go on then. It'll be fine. The wedding's still days away.
Thank you, Mira. I knew I could count on you.
What do you think you're doing?
Surprised to see me, eh? Because the way you left me, you can't have thought you were going to see me again.
How did you escape the guard?
I got my hand on a rock. I hit him over and over. I may not look like much, but I know how to survive. And he deserved what he got for what he tried to do to you. But I'm here to warn you. I was down in Fleabottom last night when I overheard a couple of Lannister guards talking about...
Shh!
They already know he's missing, probably dead. They're questioning people, searching for his body. It's not safe.
Who are they questioning? Do they know about me?
I don't think so. But why would they have any reason? Anyway, he'll never show up again to tell them. What? What is it? If we're gonna survive this, there can't be any details we've overlooked.
Someone paid him to kill me. They're still out there. They might try again.
Oh, God. You need to keep your head down. Stay out of sight for a while.
How? Do you forget who I serve?
Just keep your eyes open, and I'll watch your back. We're in this together now. My name's Tom, and I'll do what I can, but we still don't know why a Lannister guard wanted you dead.
Mira.
My lady.
Really? A tryst in the bushes with that coal boy? Not to say it's wrong, but with all the lords and knights in King's Landing, you just don't want to spoil your chances of a good marriage. Oh, thank the gods you came along, Sarah. That boy. He fancies me. He'll find any excuse to talk. I just don't have the heart to drive him off. So you misled him? I wouldn't waste the time. Come on. Marjorie expects us at the throne room. We don't want to be late. You can tell me all about this Lord Tarwick on the way. Well, first of all, his name's Garibald, and he has this really funny accent. He told me the cleverest story about this festival they have where they celebrate.
And I've given the musicians a list of songs to play for Joffrey at the feast. I assume you have no problems with the Reigns of Castamere?
I trust you've chosen all the standards. But just to be sure, I'll draw up a list of wedding ballads we favor in Highgarden.
Your Grace? My lady?
Which reminds me, Joffrey will require his Kingsguard close at hand during the feast. I'm afraid we'll have no room for your handmaidens.
But we...
What was that? Do you object? Is that what I heard? If you're going
Your
to
Grace,
speak out of turn, girl... You should finish what you start. Your handmaiden seems to have lost her tongue. Perhaps we should introduce her to Sir Ilan Payne. I believe our headsman's in need of a bride. In any case, it's settled. The Kingsguard will stay with Joffrey. Your handmaidens will sit elsewhere.
Of course, Your Grace. Anything for my beloved Joffrey.
Lady Marjorie, we may not see eye to eye on everything, but I hope you will at least agree with me that our handmaidens should know their place. And that place is not with my brother, Tyrion.
What did she mean by that? You and Tyrion? What you do reflects on me. If something's going on, I need to know about it.
Tyrion... he offered to help my family.
He did? Then surely he expects something in return. Sarah, what do you know of this?
Tyrion approached us, my lady. It was his idea, not Mira's.
I don't care what your intentions were, Mira. You went to a Lannister behind my back. I've only ever tried to help you. Why are you making trouble for me?
My family needs me. We're losing everything. I have to do whatever I can to help them.
I'm not blind to your pain, Mira. But your problems are not the only ones in the world. Right now, I need you both to be my handmaidens, and that's all I need you to be. Let there be no mistake. If I hear of you speaking so much as a word to Tyrion Lannister again, you can go home to your family.
I'm sorry, my lady. I made a mistake. It won't happen again. Please, don't send me home.
This can't happen again.
Roderick, it's the White Hills. They're assembling in the courtyard. They've woken the house. You can't let this go on. They want to see us cower.
I'll need my sentinel. Go ahead, Talia, and have Roiland meet me in the courtyard.
What is this?
It's a parade of dead men if I have my way.
Ends now! Get out of my sight!
Those are strong words for a cripple.
All of you, know your respect, Griff White, fourth-born son of Lord Whitehill and commander of this.
Cocky Roderick, we used to call you. Swinging your prick round, lording it over my family. Now look at you, hey? Roderick the Ruined. Hardly reckon. Don't say. Pathetic.
Make no mistake, Griff. I'm still the Lord of Ironwrath, and I run this house.
That sounds like the old Roderick, beating his chest every chance he got. I don't think he gets it.
No, my lord. I don't think he does.
Your brother Ethan didn't get.
Bite your tongue.
I am in charge now! And the first thing you need to know is that if I am not happy, no one will be happy. Men are taking over your great hall. That's where we'll quarter from now on.
What? You can't!
You'll have to go through me!
I'm sleeping out in your in shit and filth. Maybe that's how foresters live, but not us.
I don't care if you're happy or not, you'll quarter where I tell you.
Fucking ass, Roderick. And what's you men right? You've done. And if they're eating wormy bread, then your people better be eating shit off the ground. I'm not here to keep them in line. I'm here to keep you in line.
If your men don't like it here, you can march them back to High Point.
Watch yourself, Roderick.
This is against the King's law. You've no right to make such demands.
I have every right. We're here under the orders of Bolton. Warden of the North. So I will be in your halls. I will be in your courtyard. I will sit on your fucking council and be in your bedchambers if I bloody well please.
You can't do this, little bastard. You can't just do whatever.
We'll do what we were sent here to do.
You're mad, Griff. This is my house and you will do as I say.
Why should I listen to some cripple with half a face? Now, Me and my men will take our place in your hall. Unless you think you and your army can stop me. No, you know better than that. You know where we'll be.
This is outrageous.
Roderick, you can't let them do this.
You can't go in there.
We can and we will. Unless you want this all to end right now, eh? I'm the only lord here.
Come on.
Griff Whitehill, that snot-nosed fourthborn, parading in here like a conquering fucking hero.
It was bad enough when it was just the soldiers.
We can't live with them under our roof, soiling our house.
I know you tried to stop them, my lord. But we can only take this occupation for so long. Our people will break, and the way Griff Whitehill came in, what he wants.
Whether he rides out or
good, my lord. But Griff Whitehill isn't the beginning of our troubles, or the end of them. We need to look at all the pieces. Whitehill men aren't just in our house. They've raided our lands, burnt farms and cut down our trees. All the way from here to High Point.
How do we kill a snake, then? By smashing its head.
Griff isn't the head. It's his father.
Perhaps. But Griff is here. We have access to him.
And they have Ryan. He carved these soldiers himself. I don't care what Gwyn Whitehill may have told you at the funeral. Who knows what horrors they're putting him through, held prisoner at High Point. You can't forsake his safety.
But we have to do something. My lord, at least give us a target to aim for.
Get Ryan out and bring him home. Once he's safe, he can face the Whitehills head on.
And what of Griff and his men? But we can only take this occupation for so long.
Speak true. Would you just let Ryan die?
No, my lord.
Roderick is right. We are nothing if we leave Ryan behind.
Then it's decided. We're bringing Ryan back.
We still don't have the men to hold our own home, let alone storm High Point. We lost most of our men with Gregor at the Twins.
Unfortunately, Roderick was not able to secure the backing of the Glenmores. That means we have to count on Asher and Myrra.
How?
Asher means to sail home from Essos with a company of hardened sellswords. But they're not bannermen. We'll need to pay them for it. Which is why Myrra's part to play is just as crucial. She can get us the coin we need in King's Landing.
You don't imagine we have the luxury of waiting for them. Asher and Myrra are a long way from here.
I have faith in my children.
I don't think Lud Whitehall will kindly stand by while we pull ourselves together.
We press on. It's no use waiting.
We have a plan, my lord. But we must wait for the pieces to come together. The Whitehills aren't ready for war.
It won't be long before you're able to take action yourself.
Well, one way or another, there's a fight brewing, so I have much to prepare, and men to train.
My lord?
My lord.
There may be something we can do now.
A voice from Highpoint, Gwyn Whitehill.
I spoke with her at the funeral.
As did I. And she's willing to meet. Away from her father's guards. I may not be your sentinel. But please consider this. It would be wise to hear what she has to say. I understand your hesitation.
Arrange a meeting. What she has to say may prove useful.
I believe she can be trusted. But best use caution nonetheless.
Of course.
And I'll make sure no one else knows. For now at least.
Good.
Handle things right with Gwyn. And she may even help us in Highpoint. When the time comes.
I want the dove pie served with a spoon of lemon cream. We'll have to let the kitchens know. Wrong in the Crown Land.
Marjorie, tidings to you today.
Thank you, Lord Tyrion.
And you, Lady Mira. A word in private, if I may. I'll return her shortly.
Who would I be to deny Lord Tyrion?
Very soon you'll be the queen, and if you're anything like the current one, you'll deny me all you like.
I'm sorry, Lord Tyrion, but Lady Marjorie needs me.
Very well. Just know that matter we discussed? A royal decree sits on my desk now, and I'll have my squire Podrick see to it at the first opportunity. I thought you would want to know. News on a day...
Telling me, Lord...
Favor unspent. Perhaps I'll call on
Marjorie.
Welcome to the family. For better or worse.
Just how is he helping? What's this talk of a decree? You know I didn't know talking to him.
I made a deal with him. For the my family's ironwood.
Think of how this will look. House Forrester already has a few friends. And when this decree becomes public, you may find you have even fewer.
You disappoint me, Mira.
We'll talk about this after the wedding. Sarah will help me with my gown and hair.
But...
Come with me, Sarah.
Garrett!
Easy now.
Sorry. I was just... keeping at the ready.
That's good. Don't lose that. I understand your uncle paid you a visit. What did he want? Not many people pass through here. What brought him this far?
He was just delivering ironwood shields for the Night's Watch.
Good. Our stocks are running low. I know it couldn't be easy seeing him, but you have to leave all that behind. Especially now that you're a ranger.
Aye.
I know you had told me you could stand with these men, but not every brother's a friend, if it came to it. And you were in trouble north of the wall. Any of them you'd trust by your side? You know these men. Who do you want watching your back?
Cotter's a clever one. He could be a real help.
I'm glad you can trust your brother. I'll remember him.
Erolt Holt of White Harbor, Corliss Wells from Stony Sept. And finally, we've got more spawn of nobility joining us.
No.
Brit Warwick of House Whitehill.
It can't be.
House Whitehill. Make sure you're not bringing this one to the Boltons.
There'll be a hot meal in the mess hall. After that, we'll be sorting out gear at the armory.
Gary.
There'll be practice swords to
Gary,
start.
What's the matter?
Don't want anyone
you know him.
Their balls. Come on, get moving.
Garrett, who is he?
That man murdered my family.
What?
Snow! See these new recruits to the Maester.
Don't do something you regret.
If it isn't the fucking pig farmer. I'm here because of you. Got sent to the wall for that little party I do with your family. Don't think it's over. Best watch your back.
What are you waiting for, recruit?
Talk all you like. You'll be dead before you take the black.
Careful now. Didn't end so well for you last time.
That's enough, both of you. I said move.
I'll be seeing you, farm boy.
This isn't fair. We were supposed to be up there. I'll never see another wedding like this. I don't know what you did with Tyrion Lannister that made Cersei want to punish you, but it never should have affected me like this.
You just don't get it, Sarah. I've been fighting for my family's lives here, and what Tyrion Lannister did for me, it may have saved them. Whether you have a seat at the wedding just isn't as important.
I see. Well, I hope it was worth it, because you don't know how furious Margaery is at you. When I was getting her dressed for the wedding, she was talking about who she could replace you with. I probably shouldn't have even told you, but I suppose you have a right to know.
Tell me who it is.
Why? What are you going to do to her?
Sarah!
It doesn't matter. It was just names. This is about you. It's funny how things change, isn't it? I seem to remember, not too long ago, I was asking for your help with Margaery. And now here we are, with you on the outside needing my help. So, go on, ask me for it. Unless you want Margaery to make you leave King's Landing.
I'm not going to beg you. I can handle Margaery on my own.
You're wrong, Mira. We need each other. But if you don't feel the same by this point, fine.
Look, the pie!
Oh no, they're already serving the pie.
Oi!
We're missing everything.
I know you. You were in the gardens the other night with Damien. Before he disappeared. I have a few questions to ask you. What were you doing there with him?
Mira?
Don't think I don't know it was you.
You've made a mistake.
Seven hells.
You there, girl. I need a towel or a wet cloth, something.
Lord Morgren.
You'll need to find someone else. I'm not finished
with
her.
Are you sick, man? You think I have time to bother with handmaidens? Release her, or I'll have Queen Cersei find you another job. Well, I just ruined a perfectly good shirt to come to your rescue. No need to explain what that was all about.
That was kind of you. I do appreciate it.
Well, I didn't do it merely for your benefit.
Then why?
Perhaps I recognize a kindred spirit. It's not every little handmaiden who can steal an ironwood decree with the crown right out from under my nose.
Consider me impressed. My partners, I am afraid to say, felt rather differently about it.
That ironwood was stolen from my family. It was never yours to sell.
Spoken with strength, my lady. But still, I wonder if you're ready to play this game. Do you even understand why Tyrion gave you the ironwood deal? Because it wasn't out of the kindness of his heart.
I'm no fool. He wants something from me. Access to Margaery. Or perhaps he just knew he could get the cheapest ironwood from me.
Very observant. You are no mere handmaiden. I remember what it was like to be new to this game.
You feel like you're drowning, don't you? But there's no one you can really trust. What you need more than anything is an ally. I could be that for you, Lady Mira.
Is that something you'd be interested in?
I don't know you, my lord. I have no reason to trust you. I can do just fine on my own.
Can you? Circumstances have put us at odds. But what if we were to work together? Control the price of ironwood together? We could get very, very rich together. Or should I go back to Lord Whitehill? Who has proven to be very interested in it. I'm afraid it just became a very time to be Tyrion Lannister. Tell me that you got that ironwood decree from him.
Oh no. He said it was waiting for me on his...
What a shame. Such potential. I'm afraid any chance of our alliance has become quite impossible. You understand, Lady Mira.
I can get it. I'll get it back from his chamber.
That would not be an easy task. Especially now. But if it were to disappear, perhaps we could talk again. You have a good head for business, Lady Mira. It'd be terribly disappointing to see it on the end of a pike.
Locked. You're not getting in this way.
Tom!
What in seven hells do you think you're doing up here? What are you thinking? You've got to leave. Now.
Tom. I'm in trouble. There's something inside I need to get. If I don't, it's going to be a nightmare.
Damn it. Whatever trouble you're in could be trouble for me too.
So what do we do?
I have an idea. The terrace.
The what?
I could maybe climb across the roof and drop down onto the outside terrace. It's just... I don't know, Mira. Is whatever's in there really worth risking my life for? It's not just kings who die stupidly around here.
Tom, I really need your help here. I can't do this alone. Just be careful.
Wait here. I'll be at the door before you know it.
Just what do you think you're doing here? You shouldn't be anywhere near this place. Don't you know the imp has murdered the king?
I work for Lady Margaery. Queen Margaery. She asked me to wait here.
Somehow I find that hard to believe. I'm not going to ask you again. Oi! Whoever's in there! command you to open this door at once, in the name of the king! You, don't move.
Tom, it's me, hurry!
Gods, that was close. I almost didn't make it back down here. Some tiles on the roof came loose.
Tom, we have to hurry. I'm looking for a piece of paper. A royal decree.
Well, go on. That Lannister guard could be back with help any second. I'll keep watch outside the door.
Tom!
You can do this.
He said that it would be on his desk. Just a letter from Tywin Lannister. Tyrion Strongbox! Oh, it must be in here.
Mira, I think the Lannister guard is back.
No, it's the other one.
Damn it, hide! I'll find a way to distract them.
I'm telling you, I heard someone in here.
Search the place. We'll find them. And after. Now that we've got the imp's keys, we can have a little look inside his lockboxes, eh?
Aye.
Help! Fire!
What the hell? Damn it! Come on!
You did it. How?
I lit a tapestry on fire, down the hall. I bought you a minute, maybe two.
Oh, thank you.
Did you find it?
Oh, I think it has to be in here. Oh, it has to be. Oh.
Come on!
It worked! Is this? Oh, thank the gods! Oh, I found it!
Finally! Let's go!
If I catch the bastard who... I'll wring their bloody neck!
Not far now. Gwyn Whitehill may already be there.
What is this? Our ironwood trees. It's the Whitehills. You see what they've done? This track was hundreds of years old.
It's all gone. There's nothing but stumps.
The Whitehills need to answer for this. And Gwyn needs to answer for this. But we need to find out what she knows. She'll be over there. Be cautious, my lord. If she go around her father to help us, she must have some purpose.
She's taken a risk in meeting me. Let me hear what she has to say before I judge her reasons.
Of course. Just be wary. You see what her family's done here.
Here. You might want this. You may have known each other since you were children.
Doesn't hurt to be careful.
Go on. I'll stay with the horses.
I see you haven't lost your warrior's ways. That's good. I wouldn't want to deal with someone careless.
Hello, Gwyn.
Roderick. You saw my father's work over there, didn't you? There's no way to miss it.
And he won't stop. He means to do that to every inch of your land.
Soon, there will be nothing left to save. I hope you come with help, Gwyn.
And I hope you'll listen to me. I come as a friend. I wasn't sure you were even going to show. We're taking a risk, meeting like this. Unfortunately, it's the way it has to be.
Thank you for paying respects to my father and brother. And for coming tonight. It's good to see you again.
And you too, Roderick. I think we can help each other. But first, I've heard news of Asher. That he plans to return to Ironwrath. Why is he coming back? I loved him once. I longed for Asher to come back. But not like this.
How do you know about my brother?
That's part of why I'm here. But I need to know you've come for the same reasons I have. No more bloodshed. What you want... You say it wrong. Will you work with me to bring an end to this war?
Peace means my family. Of course that's what I want.
The years... waiting back. Why do you think he sent my brother? So there will be trouble. My father will bring utter ruin on your house. Unless you let Griff feel like he's in control. Refuse to kiss my father's ring. But you would be wise to show more respect to Griff.
I'll put on a good face and let him think whatever he likes, if that's what I have to do.
It is.
My lord, a band of riders approach from the north.
Seven hells. My father's guards must be tracking me. If they catch us here, they'll kill you.
Then we've no time to waste. Let's get on with it.
My father is planning to make a move against your family. I don't know all the details, but he's been sending a great deal of gold to someone in King's Landing. I fear for your family, Roderick.
You may think you've nothing more to lose. He is ready to show you otherwise.
What the hell is your father planning?
I swear I don't know, but whatever it is, he knows all your weaknesses, all your plans.
What? How?
Because you have a traitor in your council. And who knows a tale of your circumstances. My father boasts of it. And
you must... Who is it?
I don't know. We know you're planning to rescue Ryan. Even if it means abandoning your home to Griff.
What?
My father's guards are close. I need to know you'll do what I've asked. Promise me you'll submit to Griff. If you want peace between our families, it's the only way.
You have my word, Gwyn. I'll do my part.
Thank you.
My lord, those riders are nearly upon us. We have to go.
What I told you. Be careful what you do with it. And remember, I'll hear about it if you don't.
My lord?
Come along, Duncan.
Mother.
Roderick. Look at what's become of our house. You were nowhere to be found, and they just... Oh, they are vile men. Where were you? We need you here to hold this house together.
Mother, I went to see Gwyn Whitehill.
You did what? You would meet with the girl who once tore this house apart. Oh, I see now why you went in secret. Surely you must have known I would have counseled against it.
She wants to help us. She wants to bring about peace. And as much as you may mistrust her, we need help.
I don't know how you can trust that. Well, what did she have to say?
Lord Whitehill is plotting against us. I don't know his plans, but I fear them. And the only way he'll stop is if we submit to Griff's rule of our house.
What? Would you really give up control of our house? Griff is already a torment. How much worse could it get?
I have to keep the peace with Griff, even if that means letting him have his way at times.
The thought of it makes me ill.
I don't like it either.
Was this all? Did you learn anything more? You need to tell me.
What I've told you is nothing compared to what else I've learned. There is a traitor in our house, on our council.
No, this can't be. And all our plans to save Ryan, to save this house.
All gone.
Roderick, who could have turned on us? Times have been hard, but I never thought this would happen. Not in our house.
I have to say, Maester Ortengren worries me the most.
Perhaps. But what about Duncan?
Duncan?
He was furious when Ethan didn't choose him as sentinel. He wouldn't even show his face when Ramsay's here. When the bastard... my... I don't know anything that girl told you. The White Hills would love to sow dissent in our house with lies of traitors.
Get in there! Go on, get in there.
Get in there. Get in there. Get in there. Oh, you do what you're told.
Please, I just
leave. No, they were standing over there. Fucking was.
No, no, no.
Get down.
Get off. Stay put and stay out of sight.
Get down there.
Get off again.
Get down there and die like a good lady.
What do you want from me?
No, he was over there.
And Ramsay was
I'll
here.
I'll play it how I want.
You will bend the knee to your liege lord.
I must speak true. I haven't the balls to defy you, lord.
What is this? What are you bastards doing?
Oh, look here. It's the new lord.
You're in luck. We're just getting to the best part. Little Lord Ethan's final breath. Unless you want to play the Lord of House Forrester instead.
You can't do this. You can't do this. Get out of our house right now.
We'll do as we please. Besides, we're not finished.
You must stop.
I know you've seen it before, but it gets better every time. Just watch.
Oh, please, no!
Say hello to your father.
Oh, no, Ethan!
He's down.
Oh, well done, well done. I'd say he died better than the real Ethan.
Better than the real Ethan.
What about you, eh? You want to be next?
Men without honor are lower than dogs.
I'd be happy to dirty my blade with your blood.
What? This ends now. It's over.
Make his mother watch.
No more
now we'll really have some fun.
Enough. Griff will deal with him. When he's done, he'll own this fucking house. And you'll regret what you've done here.
Take your boy out of here while you still can.
Roderick! Roderick!
Now is not.
Wendell, pack the extra rations. Duff, make sure the quivers are full and the torches are dry. Garrod.
What's happening?
We're heading north of the wall to deliver justice to brothers turned traitor. They're hiding in the woods at a place called Craster's Keep. I've been looking for volunteers. The cowards murdered Commander Mormon. We're going to kill every one of them.
I'll volunteer to go.
I thank you for that. I need every sword I can get. But Britt's going to. He took his vows in the sect. He's a brother now. I understand why you hate him. But bad blood could jeopardize this mission. Too many unknowns out there. I can't have my own men killing each other.
I'll go in his place. I'm a better fighter than Britt. You'll want my sword before his.
I don't doubt your skill, but I need every sword that's willing to go. Even someone like Britt. If you do come, I need to know there won't be any trouble. Even if he provokes you.
Can I count on you? I need your word, Garrod. I'll be taking a chance.
I understand. You won't have any trouble from me.
I'll hold you to that. It's a hard road to Craster's. We leave tomorrow at first light.
Now why don't you go talk to those two? They volunteered as well, make sure they're ready.
Duff! Where are my arrows?
Well, what did Jon Snow say? I don't think he likes us much.
Definitely doesn't like you, Finn.
Haven't heard him singing your praises any.
He wants to see us work together. No more problems.
That's on you.
Point is, he doesn't want any problems with either of you on this Craster's mission.
Well, there's something you should know, then. I borrowed this from you.
What?
I just got curious. Oh, I wanted to know why your uncle was here.
It never ends with you.
Oh, I didn't mean no harm, honest. I just wanted a quick look. I wasn't stealing. Always planned on giving it back.
You can't keep doing that, Cotter. Next time, ask.
Well, I did try. And you just said your uncle was here about Ironwood. But I think it was something else. I noticed this part here.
North Grove. That's just some shit story for little kids. A rumor.
No, it's not.
Of course it is. I heard it's a witch's den where they turn children into giants. Garrod. You don't actually take it seriously, do you? It's a fairy tale. For idiots. Everyone knows that. Didn't think you were that gullible.
Lord Forrester knew all about it. It's a fortress. Hidden from the world.
And this says it's somewhere in the north. On the other side of the wall.
And here I thought you might have some brains, Garrod. You two deserve each other. Have fun chasing your tails.
Good. Didn't need him anyway.
What do you mean?
He doesn't know about the mammoths. Or White Walkers. Or how to sneak past a giant.
What, and you do?
But you know, it's the things you hear about. The rumours is all. I wouldn't know myself.
Rumours my arse. You're hiding something, Cotter.
I'm not. They're just things I hear around Castle Blacksall. People talk, you know.
About the North Grove, they don't.
But you do. Probably heard you talking about it. Or maybe one of the recruits.
Cotter, I know you're lying. I covered for you. You owe me.
All right. All right. I've been on the other side of the wall, Garrett. You see, I live there. In the north. I'm part of the free folk. People round here call wildlings. I know it's crazy. I was with some other free folk. We were looking for weapons, south of the wall. We got caught. So I passed myself off as a local and, well, they sentenced me here to Castle Black for stealing. I shouldn't be here. This isn't my place. I didn't know what else to do. You're quiet. I hope that means you'll keep this quiet. Are we... we still friends? I mean, I know it's a lot to take in.
Don't worry. Bloodthirsty wildling or not, we're still brothers.
That is good to hear. At least when Mance Raider wants to boil you alive, you'll know someone in high places.
Cutter! What did I say? That shithouse you fixed is still leaking!
I'll be right there. I'm going back home, no matter what, Garrett. I've heard stories. Old tales of a secret forest within a forest. Your lord knew what he was talking about.
You know where the North Grove is?
No, but I'll help you find it. I'm deserting anyway, heading back home. I can guide you, keep you alive. Stick with me and I'll show you the way.
All right. Even if you are a bloodthirsty wildling.
I won't let you down.
Cutter! Now!
On the way! Please, don't tell anyone about me. The Watch would kill me if they found out.
Marine still smells like shit, even outside the walls.
We'll find Croft here, somewhere. Yeah. You alright?
Never better. Back under the Mad King, they used to say death by sword was a sweet kiss. But fire would fuck you hard.
Funny.
No. No, not very.
I'll go find Croft's tent.
Asher... I need you to tell me the truth. I've come a long way to bring you home. Back in that cave, you made a choice. You must have thought only one of us was going to survive. Now, it's not a fair question to ask, but I need to know.
There was no time to think. Beskar was just closer.
You can lie to yourself, Asher, but don't lie to me. I know you too well. Look, I can't blame you if your feelings about me are conflicted. Or your feelings about going home. Your family exiled you to this place. But I swore an oath to your mother. Sailed halfway around the world to bring you back safe. And I'll be damned if some dragonfire or your foul decisions are gonna stop me. Are we clear? I'm here to help you. To protect you.
I'm sorry, Malcolm. I did you wrong.
Well, it's good of you to say so. But words are wind, Asher. It's choices that define who you are.
Asher, I know where Croft is.
This Croft, how well do you know him?
Too well.
I thought you said you were friends.
Yeah, we are. We are. Great friends.
Asher fucking Forrester. Son of a poxy whore.
You have some balls walking into my tent after all these years with that mama's monkey grin on your face.
Well, that went well. Great friends indeed.
You get it out your system?
Not by half. You never understood consequences, Asher. One stupid mistake cost me an eye. But you never learn. You figured you'd steal from me and I'd just forgive you? Not a fucking chance. So how are you going to pay me back? Your eye? Your hand? Or how about your tongue?
Croft, no!
Be reasonable.
I am reasonable! I'm letting him fucking choose.
My hair could use a trim. Take some off the top, would you?
Do not fucking test me!
Croft, I deserve your anger as much as Asher.
Don't worry, Beska. You're next. Now choose, or I slice off your balls, Asher.
Hey!
A man betrays my trust. There's a price to be paid.
Let him go!
Fuck you, Croft!
Have it your way. You didn't need your testicles anyway.
Oh, that was bloody beautiful. Fucking Asher. You were pale as a snow bear's arse.
Are you fucking joking?
You bloody bastard.
This is why people steal your shit and take off in the night.
Come on, you assholes. Have a drink.
Jodan, the Khaleesi's best wine.
Your friend has an interest of humor.
So what the hell are you two doing to the earth, eh?
You're a long way from young guy.
We have a proposition for you.
We need an army, Croft. My home back in Westeros is under siege.
We need your hellhounds. 100 good men.
Am I in a hobby's tin? Would I ever go back to Westeros?
I've got it good right here. Her grace pays good coin.
Did this Khaleesi make you a house cat, Croft? Curled up at her feet? Since when do you turn down an adventure?
Since the second son swore to Daenerys, bloody Targaryen. I've laid my sword at her feet, Asher.
Perhaps we could talk to her.
She's a little busy right now, commanding a fucking siege. Her enemies are nailing children up on posts for 100 miles, and a bloody dragon's gone missing.
But I know where to find her dragon.
Ha! Unfucking likely. You expect me to believe you've just happened to have seen the one fucking dragon loose in the world?
Black scales all over with a red frill running down his back.
That doesn't prove anything. Enough of this nonsense. We're done here, Asher. You two back in my life.
Uncle, show him.
Dragonfire did that.
So you rolled over into the bloody campfire in your sleep.
Croft, I've seen her dragon.
Oh, bugger me with a bloody spear. If you're lying about this, it'll cost more than your balls.
Fair enough.
Come on, you son of a bitch. The beast's name is Drogon. You'll want to hear about him right away. And don't think you're going to charm her with that fucking Asher grin.
Big day tomorrow, isn't it? Off to Craster's Keep. Assuming you're not too busy looking for your North Grove.
I thought you didn't believe in it.
Not saying I do. But if it was real, can you trust Cotter with it? You ask me. There's just something off about him. Aside from him being an oily thief, I mean. Like he's holding something back. Can't put my finger on it.
Wouldn't hurt to keep an eye on him.
Don't need to tell me that. He steals my knife, then your stuff. I'm not sure I want him walking behind me while we're out there.
Finn, Get back on watch until your relief arrives.
They're late.
You think Mance Rayder is going to wait for them?
Right. Asshole.
And Tuttle, you've got torches that have gone out. Keep them lit. Let the wildlings know we're still home.
That's ironwood for sure.
Pig farmer. A 300-mile walk, and you're still in my way.
I figured we'd settle things on the way to Crastus, but this is even better. Jon Snow can't hold your hand now.
I don't have any time for you anymore, Brit. I hate you. You hate me. Now let's move on.
Had something more painful in mind. I did duty to my lord back on that bloody farm. And for doing a proper job of it, what'd I get? Banished to the fucking wall! Never did tell you about your father, did I?
We bled him at first, like a pig. Seemed only fair he should feel what it's like. Near the end, he could barely breathe. Kept begging us to leave your sister alone, so I made sure he was still alive when she started screaming. It was the last thing your father ever heard. The more we sliced, the worse it got.
Shrieking the whole time.
You're not worth it.
I didn't come here to chat, you fucking cunt.
Too bad your father didn't fight like that. Might still be alive. And I thought you were going to make this easy. Finally getting the hang of it, Tuttle.
Stop, dammit! I don't want to fight you!
What's the matter? Don't you want to make your father proud? Let's see if you scream like your sister.
You got lucky, pig farmer. You're going to slaughter me, like my man back at your farm. At least let me have my sword. Keep it interesting. Or are you afraid?
I swore my vows. I won't kill a brother.
You're fucking pathetic, Tuttle.
Ah!
Let's fucking finish it. Go on.
We're done here.
These people are all scared, my lord. The White Hills have driven them away from the Ironwood Forests.
Out of the way!
And now they come here, starving. Food. And in the north, if we even feed a handful of peasants. Our backs are at the wall again. And this won't get better on its own.
No one has more fight in them than Asher. I'm sure he and Malcolm will find what we need.
We'd better hope we figure something out. With those White Hill bastards in the house, we must be wary.
Come on, you!
Let me go! You can't do this!
Good. You're here. Look. Look at this! Did you see what this girl did? She attacked my man like an animal.
Bloody bit me.
Yeah, now it's her turn. She's gonna get what she has coming to her. This won't go unpunished.
Let go of me.
Fine. You brought her to me. I'll deal with her.
That's not for you to decide.
I saw him stealing from our kitchen, and I told him to stop. He laid his hands on me, so I bit him.
Bloody wench.
I was only doing what had to be done.
I warned you not to mistreat my men. Someone will have to answer for this. Do you hear me? Don't make this ugly.
Your men are out of control. That's the problem here.
It's your people who don't know the order of things. This girl's as untamed as a wildling.
Don't listen to him, Roderick.
And if you can't rein her in, yeah, what about the rest of them? It's about time she saw a real lord again and learned proper discipline. They've all been missing that.
You can shout and preen all you like, but it's just for show. You do as your father Lud wishes.
And even he knows that punishing girls was never part of the deal with Ramsay Snow.
And how would you know? Eh? It was poor little Ethan who dealt with the Boltons. Oh, this house is rotten. And the problem starts at the top, Roderick.
Watch your tongue, boy.
You yourself had the gall to strike one of my men. And that's the real problem with you foresters. You're too fucking proud. Always have been. It was bad enough when you were above us. And now it's even worse. Because you don't see how far you've fallen.
Still high enough to look down at you.
Now here's a brave and wise girl. A girl who knows how to speak the truth of things.
No. A girl who should know her station! That's how I like to see you, foresters. Face down in the muck.
Talia, here.
Thank you.
You don't get it, do you? You foresters need to learn when you're beaten. You will learn some fucking humility. Or this won't be the last lesson I teach you, foresters!
Have you no honour? I'll run you through for that. I'll cut you down like straw men.
Take him, Roiland.
My bloody pleasure. I'll fucking kill you myself.
No. Make him watch this. I bet this makes you angry, eh?
You'd probably want to get up and hit me. But we know how that would go, don't we? Now, are you going to be a good little forester, learn your lesson, and stay down?
Roderick!
I said, get down! All the way down.
Get up, Roderick!
Stay down, my lord.
Your brother defied Ramsay Snow. He didn't know his place, but we made damn sure he learned. I'll probably have to teach Talia here. Unless you're a good little forester. You learn your place and stay down. Some forester is going to learn their lesson today.
Oh, I'll stay down.
Consider this even, girl. Your brother learned the lesson for you. You'd be wise to follow his lead. As would all of you. Your lord is a smart man. First in his line that understands. Now you need to understand too. You can be Lord Roderick, so long as we all know who holds the reins here. Come on.
You did the right thing, my son. You had to submit.
Aye. A true lord.
But we let them win.
You see that? He still acts like he rules the house. But he's let his guard down. So, did he get what he wanted? Or did you? At the time, I wanted you to crush him. I'm just glad you're still alive.
He thinks he's won. But he and his men have gone soft now. They won't be ready when we do strike back.
And when you're better, things will be different. I asked Ethan not to change who he was. I tried to make him promise me. I now know that was childish of me. I'm ready to change now. I'm willing to do anything to help our family. I mean it, Roderick. I don't care what. I'll do it.
That's good. I'm sure a time will come when our house will call upon you to do what's necessary. But that time is not now.
And I'm sure the others will do whatever it takes as well. What you did, yielding to Griff, you had your reasons. But...
no one can know the future. Whatever tomorrow brings, Talia, the foresters will stand tall.
We did it. I can't believe it. What are you waiting for?
I can't.
What? After everything, we just...
I can't burn it.
So, Asher Forrester, if you presume to speak of my dragons, choose your words carefully.
What have you done, Garrett? Frostfinger is calling for your head. Tell me Britt's death was an accident.
Mira, what are you doing? I can't pretend I haven't seen this. Mira, just tell me what's going on.
We are weak. We have no allies. And Griff claims... aims to be the new Lord of Ironwrath.
There's been a raven from Lord Whitehill. He's invited us to Highpoint.
Drogon wouldn't have attacked without reason.
By order of the Queen!
Fuck you and your Queen!
Deal with your friend.
Nothing ever stays in the past, Asha.
Carried. It's time to go.
That's going to be it for this episode. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to hit that like button. If you want to see more videos, hit the subscribe button. And I will see you guys on the next one. Ciao.